In this video, we're going to start the Kuta Software Infinite Algebra 2 free worksheet. You can find this worksheet under the Algebra 2 tab within the Basics section. This is review of algebraic and numeric expressions in numbers 1 through 12. We're going to be utilizing the order of operations. So let's go over that quickly. The order of operations, think of PEMDAS, or please, excuse, my dear Aunt Sally, PEMDAS, where we evaluate parentheses first, then exponents, then multiplication and division, and then addition and subtraction. So remembering this, let's look at number one. In number one, we indeed have parentheses. So we're going to evaluate what's inside of the parentheses first, and that's 7 minus 2. 7 minus 2 will give us 5, and then we still have to divide by 5. Now we're left with a single operation, division, and 5 divided by 5 is equal to 1. So our answer in number 1 is 1. In number 2, we have parentheses, addition, and an exponent. However, we have to evaluate what's inside of parentheses first. And that's this operation 3 plus 3. So we'll have 3 plus 3, which is equal to 6, since that was what was inside of the parentheses. And we're still squaring that. So now, all we have to do is evaluate our exponent. 6 squared is the same as 6 times 6, which is equal to 36. So our answer in number 2 is 36. In number 3, we're evaluating parentheses first. What's inside of the parentheses is 6 minus 3. 6 minus 3 is going to give us 3. And we still have squared left over. So we're now squaring 3. 3 squared, 3 times 3, is equal to 9. So our answer in number 3 is 9. In number 4, we have addition, parentheses, addition within the parentheses, and we also have division. So first, we're going to evaluate what's inside the parentheses, and that's going to be our addition. So we'll have 5 plus 16 plus 2, which is 18, evaluating this first, and then we're dividing that by 3. Next, remember, PEMDAS. So we're going to do multiplication or division next. That comes before addition or subtraction. So we're going to divide, and then we'll add. So we'll have 5 plus 18 divided by 3 is going to be 6. And then all we have to do is add 5 and 6 together to get 11. So for number 4, our answer is 11. In number 5, we're evaluating what's inside the parentheses first. Negative 6 times 2, a negative times a positive, is going to be a negative. So this is going to be negative 12. Since 6 times 2 is 12, negative 6 times positive 2 is negative 12. And then we're dividing by negative 3. A negative divided by a negative is going to result in a positive. 12 divided by 3 is 4, so negative 12 divided by negative 3 is a positive 4. So 4 is our solution in number 5. In number 6, we have addition and we have division. But remember, division comes before addition, so we're going to do 12 divided by 2 first. So we'll have 2 plus 12 divided by 2, which is 6, and then we're still adding 1. Now the order in which we add doesn't matter, so let's go ahead and add 2 and 6 together. 2 plus 6 will give us 8, and we're still adding 1. 8 plus 1 is equal to 9. So for number 6, our solution is 9. And with that, we reach the halfway point of the problems for this video. Before I continue on, just a friendly reminder to like this video if you're finding it helpful, and go ahead and subscribe to my channel. All likes and subscriptions are greatly appreciated. Now in number 7, we have 2 separate sets of parentheses. We'll have 1 minus 5, and we have negative 4 squared. However, there isn't an operation within these parentheses, so let's go ahead and evaluate 1 minus 5 first. So we'll have negative 4 minus 1 minus 5 will be negative 4. And we're still subtracting negative 4 squared. Now our parentheses are around both of these negative 4s, since we're subtracting a negative, it's easier to write that as opposed to writing minus a negative 4. That gets a little confusing, but the parentheses help separate the subtraction and the negative. So next, we're going to move on to exponents. So we're going to evaluate negative 4 squared. So we'll have negative 4 minus a negative 4 minus negative 4 squared is negative 4 times negative 4, which is going to result in a positive answer. 4 times 4 is 16, so we're going to have a positive 16, since negative 4 times negative 4 is a positive 16. So we have negative 4, we're subtracting a negative 4, and then we're subtracting a positive 16. You can think of this as negative 4 plus a positive 4, because subtracting a negative is the same as adding a positive. So if we add negative 4 plus 4, since we're subtracting that negative, minus 16. So we're going to do negative 4 plus 4 first, which will result in 0. So we'll have 0, moving my work over here, 0 minus 16, which will leave us with a negative 16. So negative 16 is our answer in number 7. And number 8, we have multiplication and we have subtraction. However, we have to evaluate what's inside of parentheses first, because we have PEMDAS, PEMDAS. That's the order of operations. So we'll have negative 3 times 2 times 2, and this 2 is multiplied to what's inside the parentheses. So then we're multiplying that by negative 3 minus 1, which is a negative 4. So now let's multiply. I'll multiply negative 3 with positive 2, and I'll also multiply 2 with negative 4, since the order in which we multiply doesn't matter. Negative 3 times 2 is going to give us negative 6, and that is multiplied to 2 times negative 4, which is a negative 8. Negative 6 times negative 8 is going to be a positive 48. So 48 is our solution in number 8. In number 9, we need to start with parentheses. However, we have parentheses here, and parentheses here. What we want to do is start with the innermost set of parentheses, which is this right here, 3 plus 5. So we'll have 4 minus 3 times 1 minus 3 plus 5 is 8. And then we're multiplying that by 5. So now let's evaluate what's inside of this parenthesis and inside of this parenthesis all at the same time. 4 minus 3 is 1, and we're multiplying that by 1 minus 8, which is negative 7. And then that gets multiplied to 5. 1 times negative 7 is what we'll evaluate next. 1 times negative 7 is negative 7, and we're multiplying that by 5 to get a negative 35 for our solution in number 9. Again, we have multiple sets of parentheses, but we want to do the innermost parentheses first. So here are the outermost parentheses, and then the next set of parentheses, and then finally, the innermost parentheses. So we're going to start with negative 2 plus 1. So we'll have negative 16 minus negative 2 plus 1 is going to be a negative 1. That is then multiplied by 2. And that is then divided by 5. So our next innermost parentheses, remember this parentheses is just to separate the subtraction from the negative. So our next set of parentheses we're looking at is negative 16 minus a negative 1. Evaluating that, negative 16 minus a negative 1 is the same as negative 16 plus a positive 1. So this is going to be negative 15. And then we're still multiplying that by 2, and then that quantity is then divided by 5. So our next set of parentheses is what we'll evaluate. Negative 15 times 2 is negative 30, and then we're still dividing that by 5. Negative 30 divided by 5 is a negative 6. So negative 6 is our solution in number 10. In number 11, we don't have any parentheses. However, we have multiplication, division, and subtraction. So what we want to do is start with division. So we're going to start by dividing 8 and negative 2. So 2 minus 8 divided by negative 2 minus 3 minus, this is a negative 12. So let's go ahead and add parentheses in so we can see that we're subtracting a negative. So our next step is going to be to divide negative 12 with negative 6, and then we can multiply that by negative 2. Because if we're looking at PEMDAS, we do parentheses first, then exponents, then multiplication or division, then addition or subtraction. Let's go ahead and evaluate 8 divided by negative 2 and negative 12 divided by negative 6. So we'll have 2 minus 8 divided by negative 2 is going to result in a negative 4. And then we're still subtracting 3, and we're subtracting negative 12 divided by negative 6 is going to be positive 2. And then we're multiplying that by negative 2. So our next step is to multiply 2 by negative 2. So we'll have 2 minus a negative 4. Let's just write that as plus a positive 4. Then we're subtracting 3, and we're subtracting 2 times negative 2, which is negative 4. So we'll start going left from right with addition, then subtraction, and then subtraction again. 2 plus 4 is 6. We're going to subtract 3, and then we're going to subtract negative 4. But subtracting negative 4 is the same as adding a positive 4. So we'll have 6 minus 3, which is 3, and then we're going to add 4 to that to get 7. So 7 is our solution in number 11. Just remember that when you are evaluating PEMDAS, you're going from left to right. So even though the order in which we multiply or divide doesn't matter, we need to do this division before multiplication because division comes first, going left to right. And lastly, number 12. We're going to evaluate everything within the parentheses first, and there's multiple operations within the parentheses. However, multiplication will come first. So we're going to have negative 11 minus 6 minus a negative 5, and I'll put that within parentheses so you can see that we're subtracting a negative, then adding 1, and then we're adding 3 times 2, which is 6. And then that all gets divided by a negative 5. Now I'm going to evaluate my operations from left to right within the parentheses, starting with subtraction. So I have negative 11, and I'm subtracting a positive 6. That's the same as adding a negative. So for this, I'll have negative 11 minus 6, which will be negative 17. And when we subtract a negative 5, that's the same as adding a positive 5. Then we're adding 1, adding 6, and then dividing the whole thing by negative 5. Now that I have addition left, the order doesn't really matter. So I'll do negative 17 plus 5, and I'll also do 1 plus 6 while I'm at it. Negative 17 plus 5 results in a negative 12, and I'm adding that to 1 plus 6, which is 7. And that whole thing is divided by negative 5. Negative 12 plus 7 is still within those parentheses, so I'm going to do that next. Negative 12 plus 7 is going to be a negative 5. And negative 5 divided by negative 5 results in a positive 1. So 1 is my solution in number 12. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave them in the comments section below. Also, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to my channel.